If everyone could please take your seats and get your cameras ready, we are about to begin the Francis C. Hammond Promotion Ceremony of 2016.
Thank you.
director of secondary schools in Alexandria City, to the podium. Would everyone please stand and remain standing?
Thank you and good evening. On behalf of Dr. Crawley and our school board, I'd like to welcome you to the Francis C. Hammond 2016 promotion ceremony. And congratulations to all the families, moms, dads, grandparents, cousins, parents, and guardians. You have made it through, which most of us who work in a middle school know is a very difficult time, getting through middle school. So students, we give your families a hand. Class of 2020, today you are officially ninth graders. And as you transition from admirals, let me be the first to say, once a Titan, always a Titan, that you will hear from your dean, Dean Sanders. And again, welcome to the promotion ceremony.
Thank you, Mr. Mann. Now, Ms. Perrette Hall, principal of Francis C. Hammond Middle School, will give congratulatory remarks.
Welcome, eighth graders, our eighth grade students, parents, family members, and honored guests. My name is Perrette Hall, and I'm the very proud principal of Francis C. Hammond Middle School. Eighth grade promotion is a time of completion, a time of finishing, and a time of ending. It is the culmination of your K through 8 academic career. It is also time to celebrate your new achievement and embark upon your beginning at T.C. Wiliams High School. Hammond has made great strides, and it's because of our eighth graders that are sitting in front of us today that we've had amazing success this year. This eighth grade class contains musicians, scientists, actors, politicians, lawyers. The list goes on and on, but more importantly, this eighth grade class contains scholars, and they also contain champions. And I'm excited about the potential of your success. As you enjoy today's celebration and embark on your last day at Hammond, and head to T.C. Wiliams High School, I hope that we have equipped you with all that you need to be successful. I hope that we have taught you that you are special. I hope that we have taught you that you are unique and infinite and have infinite worth. I hope that you have learned to respect and value yourself and also share that respect and value with others. We wish you much success in all of your endeavors, knowing that Francis C. Hammond Middle School will always be here to support you. So we hope that you come back to visit us and tell us about all the amazing things that you're doing. You are spending your last few minutes with us, and as Mr. Mann said, when you depart, you leave as Titans.
Thank you so much, Ms. Hall. I have the great pleasure of now introducing Ms. Carmen Sanders, your new Dean of Students for the rising T.C. Wiliams Class of 2020.
Good evening, everyone. Greetings, distinguished guests, faculty, families, and friends. I am Carmen Sanders, and welcome to T.C. Wiliams High School, where the T stands for true, the C stands for champions, and the W stands for work. It will be my distinct pleasure to serve as your Dean of Students during your 4 years of high school. As many of you learned during the Hello High School program at the Minnie Howard campus this year, what you do once you enter into high school matters. Take your academics seriously and immediately find a club, organization, or sports team and become connected to the school community. Develop healthy relationships with your teachers and your peers. The alliances that you create should be positive and challenge you to be the best version of yourself. Class of 2020, I am depending on you to excel to higher heights with clear vision and develop a plan for your future with the support of myself, your counselors, your social workers, and your parents. I am looking forward to this journey, and I hope you are too. Once again, welcome. And remember, once a Titan, always a Titan. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Ms. Sanders. I now invite Mr. Tim Brannon, coordinator of the International Academy, to give us some special remarks.
T.C. Wiliams, class of 2020, I'd like to begin tonight by thanking a few people who made tonight possible. First, I'd like to thank Ms. Hall for all the work she has done this year. We're all indebted to her for the culture she has worked to instill at Hammond in her first year. Thank you, Ms. Hall. Secondly, I'd like to thank the eighth grade staff. In addition to their diligent work in providing you with instructional and emotional support all year, they have poured their souls into making sure you had a great last week of middle school. Between the beautiful dance they set up for you on Friday, to the ceremony tonight, and all the events in between, I hope you all can see how much they care about each and every one of you. I was asked to speak tonight about the transition to high school and offer my thoughts on what you could do to make the most of your time there. At the beginning of this year, Ms. Hall asked us to be champions for you, and she asked you to consider yourself champions as well. That is a message you have heard throughout the year, and I hope it's a message that you carry with you into your future. It's a message that I've thought a lot about. What is a champion? Someone that is successful, someone that meets their goals, someone who wins. We can all define what a champion is, but it's important to know how one becomes a champion. To me, a champion is someone who takes control of their own future. As you go into high school and beyond, it is important to realize the extreme power you have to control your life and that you have the right to make choices for yourself. You get to decide your classes, join clubs, choose the college and career you want to go to and have, and you get to pick your friends. With this power to control your own future, it is important to get comfortable taking risks. Champions take risks. High school is a time to try new things and challenge yourself to do something that you did not think that you could do. Take a class you're interested in. Raise your hand and answer a difficult question. Help someone in need. Admit that you don't know something and ask for help. Challenge the thoughts of those you disagree with, even if it is an adult. Run for student council. Try out for your favorite sport. Become friends with people who are not like you. Choose friends who support you and lose friends who do not. For you to take risks and make them be worthwhile, you can't be afraid to fail. A big part of learning and becoming your best self is your response to failure. Champions see failure as an opportunity to learn and improve themselves. They experience failure and they persevere. They work harder, they learn more, they ask for help from those who support them, and they keep their eyes on their goal. Everyone you look up to has failed at some point. LeBron James has lost the NBA championship 4 times. Bill Gates' first business failed. Steve Jobs was demoted from Apple, the company he created. And Barack Obama lost his first congressional election. None of these people accepted their failures as the end. They knew that if you give up after you fail, you allow that failure to define you. If you accept that failure, you learn from it, and you work to do better, you give yourself the agency to define who you are, a champion. Class of 2020, you're all champions for what you have done thus far. I think I can speak for the entire staff when I say that we are very proud of you, and we look forward to seeing what you can achieve in your future. Thank you and congratulations.
Thank you so much, Mr. Brannon. I would now like to invite Nawal Gall to come to the stage to deliver some reflections.
Done? Okay. Good evening, families, staff, and fellow graduates, and thank you for attending our graduation ceremony. Today is the day we end our most memorable years in the place we will always call home, Francis C. Hammond. Before I begin, I would like to thank all of our school staff and parents who believed in us before we could even believe in ourselves. Graduates, you should know your parents are very proud of you today. They have high hopes for you and believe in you. You can see them now. Look at them now. You can see them with that great big smile on their face, recording everything so they can cherish this moment forever. The first day of sixth grade, we were children, scared to take on the world. And look at us now, class of 2020. We have all grown, whether it was physically, emotionally, mentally, and socially. These past 3 years has been a roller coaster filled with growth and emotion, not only for me, but for my peers also. We all have had our ups and downs, but that is what makes us who we are. This school has given us so much knowledge and potential, and that will be marked in our hearts until the end of time. What we have learned in middle school will be carried with us throughout high school, and then to high school. What we have learned in middle school will be carried with us throughout high school, then to college, and whatever else may come. Today is the day that we grow up. Today is the day that we celebrate us as young adults on our great achievement and perseverances. As we grow up, we're going to meet teachers, coaches, and even your own peers who tell you that you can't do it because of your skin color, who you are, where you came from. But I'm going to tell you something. You can't let those people bring you down. And when they do, that is where you're going to show them how strong you are. That is where you're going to show them what you are capable of. We represent all of the young people, and we are the role models to the future generation. You need to be able to fight for what you believe in, and what you believe in should be yourself. So push and fight and have faith in yourself, because you can do anything. There isn't enough time in the world for procrastination. Later in life, you don't want to look back and regret the things that you were capable of. We are the future, and now is our time. As we say goodbye to teams 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Don't forget to just keep swimming. Thank you.
Noelle, thank you so much for that powerful and inspiring speech. The class of 2020 would now like to recognize and thank certain members of the Francis C. Hammond community who have helped to make this year possible. Would Christian Burrell please come to the stage to present these recognitions?
Good evening. I'm honored to stand before you today to present these awards to 8 people who make the entire school operate. These individuals are the ones who go the extra mile and constantly work to make Francis C. Hammond have that great and impressive learning environment that it has today. They are the ones who are best at being compassionate and fair, no matter who the person or the individual. These individuals help anchor 500 eighth grade students to be the outstanding people that they are meant to be, and that is not an easy job. All of these fellow staff members exemplify what it means to truly be an admiral. Thank you for all that you do. Ms. Alfaro, Ms. Washington, Ms. Square, Ms. Daniels, Ms. Minlarini, Ms. Brannon, Mr. Barnes, and Ms. Hall.
Thank you.
Thank you so much, Christian. We are now going to begin our presentation of special awards. Would Ms. Petty and Ms. Longbowles please come forward to present the Arts, Career, and World Language Awards.
Good evening, everyone, and you all look so lovely and welcome. Anyway, the first award that I have to present today is the Helen Neal Distinguished Business Student Award. And I must say something about Helen Neal first before I give this award out. First of all, Helen Neal was a teacher that actually taught at Hammond about 30 years, and she did all her years at Hammond Middle School, basically, and when it was a high school, junior, and everything else, too. She dedicated herself to teaching business courses, and during her years there, she instilled in her students to embrace learning and to get ready for the world, the real world that's outside. She would always say to me, "We have more things to learn, so don't get contented." And she was constantly improving her educational value. And how she did that was by taking classes, going to conferences, and she always volunteered for extra assignments. She did curriculum writing, not only at the local level, but also at the state level. And she was always revising and updating all of the business courses that we have at the middle school level, which we do teach some now today. She was often sought out for her expertise as a teacher by teachers, other teachers, as well as other state specialists as well. She loved to create fun and exciting instructional materials, which was a passion of hers. Not just relying on textbooks, she really wanted to go the whole nine yards to make learning meaningful to her students. I am pleased to say that she was my mentor and that she instilled in ways in me to take initiative as well as to have that do more attitude. And today, the student that reflects that attitude and has an outstanding performance in business and information technology and can even type over 100 words a minute, which is very impressive, he beats me, is Ashraf Hamzawi. Okay, now I'm going to present the other awards for Arts, Career, Technology, and World Languages. And I know it's going to be hard, but parents and friends, if you could hold your applause until the end, we can move in that way. The students can hear their names as well. For outstanding performance in AVID, Aisha Munir. For outstanding performance in digital art, Brian Lozama Montesino. For outstanding performance in Art 8, Alberto Galvin. Okay. Okay. Not here. Okay. For outstanding performance in Spanish 1, Aya Nugaleeva. For outstanding performance in Spanish 1B, Adriana Miles. For outstanding performance in Spanish 2, Kendrick Garcia. for Outstanding Performance in Heritage Speakers 1B, Jean-Paul Corrales Chica. For Outstanding Performance in Spanish 3, Sophia Ryer. And Sophia Ryer is also being recognized for the National Spanish Exam as well. For Outstanding Performance in French 2, Natalia Pena Cruz. For Outstanding Performance in French 2, Sarah Ryder. For Outstanding Performance in German, Kaylee Zack. For Outstanding Performance in Chinese Language Level 2, Matthew Chung. For Outstanding Performance in Symphonic 8th Grade Orchestra, Kendrick Garcia. For Outstanding Performance in Advanced Chorus, Jean-Paul Corrales Chica. For Outstanding Performance in Band, Matthew Chung. For Outstanding Performance in Band, Reese Woods. For Outstanding Performance in Reading, Josephine Osei Bonsu. For Outstanding Performance in Reading, Rakeem Smith. For Outstanding Performance in Technological Systems, Malcolm William Echo. For Outstanding Performance in Digital Input Technologies, Kennedy Barber. For Outstanding Performance in Digital Input Technologies, Sabir Kareem. For Outstanding Performance in Family and Consumer Science 3, Lourdes Rivera. For Outstanding Performance in Family and Consumer Science 3, Mia Pedraza Arnez. Now, can you give everyone an outstanding, resounding applause? No, that's not Sabir.
Thank you so much, Ms. Longbowles and Ms. Petty. I am now honored to present the Sportsmanship Awards. Would Ahite and Tena please come to the stage? Kamani Blackwell.
You giving them out? Sure. Here, want to give them to you? That's Ahita right here.
John Paul Corrales Chica. Araba Dennis. Amanita Fadika. Amaya Matthews. Isatu Ndao. And last but not least, Shamia Scott. Sorry, Shamia. Shamia Scott. Congratulations to you all, and thank you all so much for being such good sports. Our counselors are now going to present the Counselors' Awards. The 2016 Counselors' Award recipients have each demonstrated growth in his or her academic performance and have developed a positive sense of self and respect for others. We're going to start with Ms. Migliorini. Would you please come forward to present your awards?
Good evening, everyone. My name is Katie Migliorini. I'm the school counselor for the International Academy at Francis Hammond, or Team 85. I'm presenting my counselor awards to two students who have matured and grown significantly this year in many ways. Additionally, these students have learned to advocate for themselves and have also been a voice for other students who needed help and support. I'm very proud to present these awards to Angel Mezareyes and Ana Valenzuela.
Thank you, Ms. Migliorini. Would Ms. Washington now come forward to present her awards?
Good evening. I am Charissa Washington, guidance counselor for last names A through E. The students I honor this evening have matured and grown over the past few years. They have made strides academically, and their character is truly that of admirals. She has come out of her shell and has blossomed into a young lady. He has maintained his sense of humor while becoming a mature young man. It is with great pride that I present the counselor's award to Tamar Iwusi and Carlos Chavarria.
Thank you so much, Ms. Washington. Ms. Daniels will now present her awards.
Good evening. My name is Erica Daniels, and I'm the school counselor for those fabulous students that start with the letter F, all the way to those magnificent students that start with the letter M. The young man that I selected was kind of shy and kind of low-key last year. But this year, he is so outgoing. I've watched you shine socially and academically. So Avery Jordan, please come up and receive your award. Is Avery? Uh-oh. Oh. Okay, we'll make sure he gets his award. Now, this young lady has been a positive addition to our Admiral family. With her charming personality and warm smile and her stellar academic record, Amina Gant, please come get your award.
Thank you so much, Ms. Daniels. And now would Ms. Square please come forward to present her award.
Hello, you all look so beautiful. My name is Kitty Square, and I have the honor of having the end of the alphabet, N through Z, all right? So my counselor award goes to a beautiful, talented young lady who is smarter and braver than she likes to believe. She works hard and plays harder, has pushed herself in a positive way, and is oh so helpful. And I've had the honor of seeing her flourish for the last 3 years. My biggest advice to her is moving forward is to simply trust and believe she's already got it. Lourdes Rivera, get up here.
Thank you so much, Ms. Square, and congratulations. The staff of Francis Hammond is incredibly proud of each and every eighth grader. Some students, however, have gone above and beyond in one aspect or another of their school life. These special awards are meant to recognize students who have excelled in the following areas. The Francis C. Hammond Middle School Alumni Association Spirit Award recognizes students who have shown outstanding commitment to the well-being of our school. The Francis C. Hammond Admiral Award is in recognition of those students who have shown tremendous growth this year while also demonstrating perseverance, dedication, and integrity. We will recognize also those students who have had the most passion and highest performance in science, social studies, math, and language arts. We also want to recognize those students who have shown the greatest dedication and contribution to the Francis C. Hammond community with our Outstanding Student Citizenship Award. We will start with Team 8-1. Would Mr. Valle please come forward to present his students with these awards?
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I am incredibly proud to be up here representing our amazing students of the Team 8-1 Terrapins. Please give them a round of applause. And I would like to present the Francis C. Hammond Alumni Association Spirit Award to Brittany Morales. And Kendrick Garcia. The Admiral Award will be presented to Araba Dennis and Stephanie Portillo. And the Science Award will go to Jason Coker. The Social Studies Award to Mohammed El Arag. The Math Award to Aisha Munir. The English Language Arts Award will go to Jonathan Jackson. And the Citizenship Award will go to Alamatu So. And Jonathan Ramos. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, Mr. Valle, Mr. Hopkins. We will now present the special awards to Team 8-2. I would like to introduce Mr. Grooms, who will be presenting his team's awards.
What a year, what a year, what a year. It was a great year. It was a great year. A2, along with all the other teams, you really produced this year. To your parents, thank you. You gave us your best and brightest. In fact, let's give a hand to all these parents in the back. From A2 to the administration and to the counselors, thank you. It was quite a year. In A2, to have in class a bear that wear dresses, for students that are convincing their math teachers to carve out things on their faces in order for them to learn algebra, it was quite a year. But besides all that, your SOL scores, they were great, and thank you. I'd like to thank the following teachers from the students, Ms. Nelson, Dr. Beasley, Mr. Edwards, and Ms. Espiet. Spirit. When we think of spirit, this is a person that no matter what happens, they walk into the room and they lighten the room up. There's never a bad day for these kids. First up, Suzette Rimpong. On the other hand, from the guy's point of view, this guy kept the energy level. Gabriel Macias. And then we talk about this student that improved, the student that came to us that was unsure, but left with all the confidence in the world, with all the confidence. And we're talking about Christian Avalar, yes, from the Admiral Award. From the Science Award, this guy is just raking in the gold, Matthew Chung. Civics is difficult to determine. Look at all those great scholars in civics this year. Came down to one person, Hamza. For math, Christian Burrell.
All right, Christian. Woo.
From language arts, Vanessa Abaraz. Oh my goodness. Citizenship. In citizenship, we are talking about the person sort of like the top guy, top girl, but we're looking at all around. We're looking at what do they do in music? What do they do in the class? What type of classes are they taking? What are they doing in the fields, the playing fields? And this year we had so many kids to compete for that, but two came out on top. From the guys, is Matthew Chung again. Awesome. Okay. And for the girls, Sophia Kavanaugh.
Thank you so much, Mr. Grooms. We will now present the special awards to Team 8-3. Would Mr. Dwyer please come forward to present his students with these awards?
Good evening. I first want to thank the parents. You all have given the teachers an opportunity to work with your kids this year, and it's a great, great, great privilege to do that. When your students or your kids, our students, came to us as rising seventh graders, they were completely different people than they are today. Over the year, I watched your kids, our students, mature into very, very, very promising young adults. And it's the real gift that I get as a teacher to be able to do that day in and day out. We had about 110 students on our team this year, and they're students from all over the world. I grew up less than a mile from here, and I tell people I travel every day to all parts of the world, and I don't even leave Alexandria, and it's a great opportunity, and I appreciate it. Thank you. The awards tonight. The first one is for the Spirit Award, and these two people come to school every day with lots of enthusiasm, and they have a real understanding of what it is to be a part of something. And they know they're a part of Francis Hammond Middle School, and they come in an enthusiastic every day, and they try to get their fellow students to be enthusiastic as well. It's a great privilege and honor to announce the winners, Anaya Brown, who's not here tonight, and Nathaniel Henley. The Admiral Award this year goes to two gentlemen, Jose Ortiz and Caleb Navarrete. The next award is for science. Being a science teacher, I'm a little bit biased. I think this is one of the better awards that's given out tonight. This is the first time in the 10 years that I've been teaching here at Hammond that a student has actually been perfect. First quarter, second quarter, third quarter, and fourth quarter. His quarter grade was 100. for four quarters straight. Nathaniel Henley. Social studies. Thanks to Mr. Welgus and his hard work. Nazir, come on up. Get your award. Taximore. I got to close them up. Nazar, come here. Why don't you just wait over here? Come on over here. Don't want to give this away, but just wait right here, buddy. Thank you. Miss Burton Wiliams, math teacher, has selected Nazar. And Talajawa. Come on up. Talajawa Sanders. And the award for the language arts goes to Jessica Hernandez Zuniga. And thank you, Mr. Abramson. And finally, the Citizenship Award. Francis Hammond Middle School, and particularly 8-3, we focused on Admiral Pride all year. And Admiral Pride, there are certain characteristics that these students can use in the classroom, but they can also use throughout their lives. Ask any one of the students what Pride stands for, and they should be able to tell you a little bit more about it. The two students that are going to be recognized tonight, though, for the Citizenship Award demonstrated the characteristics from day one until the last day. And because of the enthusiasm that they demonstrated it with, they infected some of the other students around them. And I saw students grow because of these two students. The Citizenship Award goes to Nathan Dante, Julia Clements, D'Assis.
Thank you so much, Mr. Dwyer. We will now present the special awards to Team 8-4. Would Mr. Dever please come forward to present his students with these awards?
Thank you very much. This was my first year at Hammond, hopefully the first of many. So I bounced around the country and landed in the DC area, and I just want to thank you guys so much for making me feel at home this year. Team 8-4 We used to have meetings, and honestly, we'd sit around saying, this is really quite easy. This group's really easygoing. We don't worry about field trips. We don't worry about walking down to the gymnasium. So thank you, parents, so much for giving us your children and making our job so much easier. Thank you very much. I'll just say really quickly to sum up, we've learned a lot. Hopefully you did this year. You learned essay 1, 2, 3 in Ms. Hernandez's class. I'm sure you've tirelessly gone over your work in Mr. Hopkins and Dr. Schoenberg's math classes. We learned how to cross-examine in my class. And of course, those J-Labs in Ms. Conley's class. But we've also learned outside of the classroom lessons, like don't wear white socks with black shoes. Stay away from the green apples. Don't throw money from the bank out of your window. And last but not least, please do not combine Spanish and French terms. So, without further ado, let's get to these awards. This first one is the Alumni Association Spirit Award, and spirit is a relative term. Sometimes it's very outward. Other times it's students that are so driven that you can't help, but even though they're not emoting, you can tell that they're being very perseverant and working very hard. And Teammate 4 wants to acknowledge Ezekiel Benison and Aya Nurgalieva. Okay, this next award is the Admiral Award, which is going to someone who has grown a lot over the course of this year, and I'm very proud of this person, Israel Hernandez. The Science Award, which is given by Ms. Conley, goes to Ms. Sarah Ryder. The Social Studies Civics Award goes to Vanessa Vecchiarano. The Math Award, since my students are split between two teachers, we have two of them, goes to Ahita Antene and Sarah Ryder. And the Language Arts Award goes to Erica Thompson. And last but not least, our Citizenship Award goes to two people who were as constant as it can get in a place that isn't always constant. And it goes to Augustine Cardenas and Lourdes Rivera.
Thank you so much, Mr. Dever. We will now present the special awards to Team 8-5, and I invite Dr. Abatello to come forward to the microphone.
Thank you. Our first award for spirit goes to Tamana Aman and Alexis Baptista Cruz. Our next award, the Admiral Award, goes to Sarai Rivera Bonilla. For academic achievement in science, Talha Ali. For academic achievement in social studies, Adilawit Teklahai Manot. For academic achievement in math, Josephine Use Bonsu. For academic achievement in English language arts, Brittany Torres Salgado. And for citizenship, Luis Hernandez Ventura and Camila Diaz Oru.
Thank you so much, Dr. Abatello, and congratulations to all of our special awards recipients. I would like to invite Ms. Nancy Hernandez, our Language Arts Department Chair, to come forward to present.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. So I will be presenting the Joan Dawson Award for Excellence in English. So each language arts teacher was asked to select a student who has achieved astounding accomplishments in English language arts. The first recipient of the award was selected by Mrs. Marshall. She says, "This student possesses excellent reading comprehension and writing skills. She works hard and even challenges herself outside of class. During class discussions, I can always count on her to give a mature and well-thought-out response that goes beyond surface reading. She has been a model student and pleasure to have in the classroom. Cortland Doris, please come to the stage to receive your Joan Dawson Award." The next recipient of the award was selected by Ms. Monroe, otherwise known as Ms. Espiot. This student is an excellent writer manifested through her strong voice and sophisticated ideas. She is currently working on a novel, and we expect that she will be a published writer in the future. Not to mention, she received a perfect score on her writing SOL, so even the state recognized her genius. Audriana Miles, please come to the stage. The next recipient of the award was selected by Mr. Abramson. He says, "This student always showed enthusiasm and creativity throughout the year, going beyond expectations by seeking to challenge and express herself. Athena Salomons, please come to the stage." So Athena's not here tonight. We'll save the award for her. The next recipient of the award was selected by Mr. Garland. This student never gives up. He is known for his untiring commitment to excellence in language arts. Avery Jordan, please come to the stage. Again, not here. They're standing us up tonight. The next recipient of the award was selected by Mrs. Alger. This student has proven herself to be an insightful and diligent language arts student. Along with consistently applying what she learned about nonfiction to all of her content classes, she exhibited a talent for literary analysis and discovering connections between her self-selected readings and those chosen for the class. Fariwar Nouri, please come to the stage. The next recipient of the award was selected by Ms. Nouri. She says, "This student has been chosen to receive this award for his dedication, commitment to learning, and applying language arts skills in all educational settings. Agustin Cardenas Alvarez, please come to the stage." The final recipient of the John Dawson Award was selected by me. There are over a million words in the English language, and this student is on a tireless mission to learn them all. He pushes himself to read far beyond the required amount of reading and never allows a word to remain undefined. His curious mind will take him far in life. In addition to that, he has also stood me up. Mahmoud El Arag was the recipient. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Hernandez. Mickey Moore was a teacher at Francis C. Hammond from its opening as a high school in 1956 and later became principal of the school. This award, given in her name, recognizes those students who maintain a 4.0 GPA for the year. Vanessa Alvarez. Yina Botero Muria. Elena Browind. Christian Burrell. Sophia Cavanaugh. Matthew Chung. Hamza El Masoub. Kendrick Garcia. Akraf Hamzu.
All right,
Akraf! Nathaniel Henley. Jessica Hernandez Zuniga. Lizette Lopez Sanchez. Gabriel Macias. Amir Asalan Mata. Adriana Miles. Katarina Neubacher. Arnuleva, Aya Arnuleva. Josephine Osei Bonsa. Mia Pedraza Arnez. Sarah Ryder. Sophia Ryer. Sarah Shy. Ethan Stanford. Nazir Taxa Timor. Erica Thompson. And Kaylee Zach.
Good evening. I'm Mr. Barnes, the eighth grade academic principal. I'll be handing out two principal awards. These two students, I would say, are student role models, always engaged in their learning, also are willing to help others, and also participate in extracurricular activities. These two students are Theodora Rochelle and James Felix.
All right, it's my great pleasure to announce my selection for the Principal's Award for the International Academy this year. She's proven herself as a well-rounded student that exemplifies all that we want in our students. She's strong academically, displays exemplary character. She consistently brings positive energy to those around her, and she's a leader who's always willing to help others. Gina Botero Muriel, please come to the stage.
Thank you.
Thank you so much to our principals and congratulations, students. It is a tradition at Francis C. Hammond for a student to give the farewell address to his or her class. This year's address will be given by Hamza Elmaswab.
Good evening. My name is Hamza Elmaswab, and it is a pleasure to be standing before you, representing the entire class of 2020. Finally, we made it. We have achieved another major milestone, middle school graduation. To our teachers, who educated and encouraged us, our family members that believed in and loved us, and our administrators who supported and helped us throughout our middle school experience. We are so thankful for all of your assistance and support in reaching our goals, especially this very day. Most of all, good evening to the Francis C. Hammond class of 2020. I can remember that three short years ago, we were sixth graders just entering middle school. It was tremendously intimidating entering such a large school with a unique atmosphere, different procedures, and new people. We had all these wild thoughts, stories, and conjectures about how our middle school years were going to transpire. Then, sixth grade year, Hammond Middle School welcomed us with open arms to an environment where we can excel academically and socially. We were able to build relationships with our teachers, faculty, fellow classmates, and our school. We can all agree that middle school has been a wild ride, with accomplishments and heartbreaks. It has been like no other. We have all changed over the course of these 3 years. We have all had a variety of experiences which have taught us a lot. We understand what it feels like to be counted on, have great responsibilities, and be pushed to be the best. We sit here today and dwell on the past, which holds both amazing and difficult times. Some of those times include searching for our classrooms, getting lost in the intertwining hallways, taking part in after-school activities, for instance, clubs and sports, attending the remarkable white party, and preparing for the significant SOLs. It has been an amazing 3 years, and we shall cherish these memories and experiences, including this one, for the rest of our lives. And then, looking ahead to the next step as students, ninth grade year, where we will officially be considered high schoolers. Sorry. Certainly, it may seem intimidating finally entering high school, but I'm sure that we are all ready. As we take our past learnings and experiences, we will be able to tackle any obstacle that comes before us. As Les Brown once said, shoot for the moon. Even if you miss, you'll land among the stars. We must have perseverance and push ourselves beyond expectations and limitations to achieve greatness. We all have the talent, determination, and support needed to succeed and accomplish all of our aspirations. Once again, I would like to thank all the teachers, administrators, friends and family for helping us to reach this day, and congratulate the Hammond class of 2020. We're officially high schoolers.
Thank you, Hamza, for that wonderful speech. And now, we will present the certificates of promotion to the class of 2020. However, before we begin, we have a few requests of you to make this process go more smoothly. So that each parent can hear their child's name being called, we are asking you to please, please, please hold all applause until the end of each team. Additionally, we ask that you please remain seated during the procession. Students will be exiting and entering all aisles, so the aisles must be kept clear. Students, please remember to keep your awards with you. These awards will be presented by our eighth grade counselors. Will Team 8-1 please rise?
Mispa Ahmed, Leslie Arriaga Chavez, Natnelle Belay, Corey Billups, Kamani Blackwell, Neri Bonilla Villalobos, Zaira Bridges, Kennedy Brooks, Zacharias Brown, Dorothy Bourbon, Marquez Calderon, Kenya Castanone Barrios, Argelia Castro Perez, Orlando Clausen, Jason Coker, Amari Dancy, Kelby Darko Larby, Mayar Dowie, Araba Dennis, I'm sorry, babe, Lauren Dickerson, Ibrahima Diop, Brendan Doney, Cortland Doris, Jada Elmore, Yaslin Estrada, Joaquin Evans, Tamar Iwusi,
Shakayla Farmer, Kendrick Garcia, Edwin Gaspar Rabanales, Irushalem Getachew, Ryan Gomery, Tyga Golden, Victor Gomez Guerra, Mariah Gunnerick, Nathan Gunnison, Yasmin Hassan, DeKayla Henderson, Jonathan Hernandez, Shaina Hernandez, Elvis Hernandez Flores, Jonathan Jackson, Aisha Carbo, Manor Khan, Kiana Kadami, Zipporah Kusi Apua, Suryatu Lamin, Rebecca Lynn, Roberto Mancia de la Guila, Lisbeth Marquez, Natalia Martinez Ramirez, Daylin Miliana Kino. Aliyah Muhammad. Jared Molina Vega. Jared. Eduardo Mondragon Morales. Brittany Morales. Tia Muhammad. Aisha Munir. Makaya Muse.
Isatune Dow. Gabriella Orellana Montes. Stephanie Portillo. Natalia Pena Cruz. Cynthia Pineda Denarte. Marilla Ramirez Diaz. Jonathan Ramos. Jesse Reyes. Sophia Ryer. Sandy Romero. Eduardo Romero Granados. Jocelyn Rubio Alvarez. Theodora Rochelle. Christopher Salinas Leon. Uriel Santiago. Beckett Sarkodi Ado. Rahel Samir. Khadija Shamat. Brianna Smith Harper. Aaliyah Soto. She's coming. Let's give it up for Aaliyah. Alamatu Sao. Ethan Stanford. Shayla Tate. Victor Tercios Alvarenga. Daniela Velasquez Crosa. Avery Ward. Avery Ward. Anissa Wells. Andre Wilkes. Joey Witcher.
My boy.
Adam Yakub. Kaylee Zach. Matthew Zahalan. And Ian Zara.
A big congratulations to Team 8-1. And now, would Team 8-2 please rise?
A smile.
I'll just smile.
Lydia Arjari, Muhammad Ali, Lina Elshrawi, Denisa Alvarez, Vanessa Alvarez, Wonderful Aples, David Arbieto, Robert Arias, Christian Avalar, Adama Bangura, Kennedy Barbour, Savon Berrios, Michaela Beatty, Jason Berrios, Kofi Biney, Alexa Bogan, Francisco Bonilla Garcia, Suzette Brimpong, Christian Burrell, Diana Bynum, Sophia Cavanaugh, Thomas Silas Beliza, Cameron Chambers, Matthew Chong, Jaden Christopher, Kevin Claros Quinteros, Tavon Clayton, Isatu Koulibaly, Kiri DeLeon Hernandez, Aaron Demir, Anujan Duga, Ethan Errett, Hamza Elmaswab, Arturo Aroa, Adonis Esquivel Ramos,
Amanata Fadika, James Felix, Amina Gantz, Victor Garcia.
All right, Vic.
Calcadan Gabiso. Maria Jerome Bolanos. Michael Granados. Kevin Granados Alvarado. Jeremiah Gray. Ayman Hamid, Elijah Harris Watson, Jasmine Haynes, Anthony Hernandez, Ali Aluba Hilal,
all right, Aluba.
Janaea Giles, Gladys Kamara, Paulina Canoe, Muhammad Khan, Brianna Lacayo, Robert Longerby, Michael L. Murillo, Lizette Lopez Sanchez, Gabriel Macias, Grace Malone, Jonathan Martinez, Germany McReynolds, Melody Medina, Adriana Miles, Shaquia Mitchell,
Lizbeth Perez, Megan Perez, Sandrea Perry, Aaliyah Ramirez Arswaga, Betsy Ramos Vasquez, Erisbeth Reyes Caballero, Ian Sanchez, Ian, Mariama Sangare, Shamaya Scott, Zion Sewell, Kalisa Sharp, hey. Asanye Taylor, Hymanot Tesfe, Jacob Thiessen, Kevin Uyoa, Amy Euritia Flores, Avishay Wanzer, Javon Warren, Lamar Whiteside, Jayla Wiliams, Kaylee Winstanley.
Congratulations, teammate two. Would team 8-3 please rise?
Jamal Ali, Muhammad Ali, Abel Emanuel, Leo Amaya Cruz, Fahad Amer, Jalen Ankara Turner, Rosasella Aparicio Reyes, Angela Andrada, Jalen Ankara Turner, Rosasella Aparicio Reyes, Ahardu Arafini, Ali Avalier Virial, Ramla Ayalu, Johannes Balina, Jose Beleza Gutierrez, Gustavo Bermudez Romero, Cindy Blanco Villueva, Dante Boykin, Kalia Broadnax, Elena Browand, Peter Canis, Matthew Castillo, Kelvin Chavez Guerrero, Marquise Charles McNeil, Julia Clemens Deosis, Demarcus Coggins, Abdul Conte, Alhaji Conte, Angel Cruz, Julio Cruz Hernandez, Taven Cuthbertson, Nathan Damte, Brenda Delsid Zalea, Mahmoud Diallo, Christina Dofor, Malcolm Eckel, Valerie Eid, Kevin Espinoza Hernandez,
Giovanni Flores Oriana, Jessica Fuentes, Morgan Graves, Cavante Hall.
All right, Cavante.
Nathaniel Henley, Jessica Hernandez Zuniga, Talia Johnson, Helen Cavia, Aisha Kamara, John Kamara, Rosa Kamara, Princess Carbo, Nicole Lago Rodriguez, Umaru Lamine, Omar, Montrell Lucas, Savon Massey, Ryan Medina, Brian Madrano Perdomo, Deja Moody,
Caleb Navarrete, Katarina Neubacher, Jose Ortiz. All right, Jose. Lennox Osei Achimpong. Mia Pedraza Arnez. Shaylin Perez Perez. Naya Phelps. Edwin Pineda Calzada. Sterling Queen. Sincere Reese. Luis Rocha. Juliana Rano Galeacho. Talajua Sanders. Sarah Shai. Bahar Sultani. Jessica Talbert. Tanasia Talbert. Nazar Taxitimir. Belen Tesfay. Ober Valiente Lopez. Kevin Vargas Vega. Joey Wong. Pierce Yao. David Zales.
A big congratulations to all of Team 8-3. And now, would Team 8-4 please rise?
Parents that
we need to keep the aisles clear so the graduates can go through.
Parents, we ask that you please keep the aisles clear so that the students can pass through. Thank you. Sabria Ahmed, Ahita Antenna, Gloria Aquino Cruz, Ecclesia Acefa, Binyam Boucha, Jasmine Baxter, Ezekiel Benison, Augustine Cardenius Alvarez, Sarah Carvajal Morales, Carlos Chavarria, Jean-Paul Corrales Chica, Zamina Curry Paco, Giovanni Diaz Hernandez, Brian Diaz, Philip Duenius, Sina Ekubezgi, Ardamas Ephraim,
Brooke Fekru, Stephen Frimpong, Nawal Gall, Whitney Gamble, Stephanie Garcia Castillo, El Haji Gee, Roy Gutierrez Delgado, Mikias Hailu, Ashraf Hamzawi, Liam Hare, Adham Haba, Israel Hernandez Zelaya, John Hernandez, Elijah Horn, Yoel Isaias, Amy Jackson, Samin Jan, Olivia Johnson, Kiana Josie, Isata Kamara, Jamil Kadir, Taylor Keenan, Jennifer Lopez Aviles, Natalie Lusant, Uthman Mahdi, Dorian Marlowe, Karina Martinez, Aliana Matthews, Amaya Matthews, Darcy McElwain, Haley Merida Rabanales, Ricky Merida Miranda, Fernanda Mondragon Enriquez, Abe Mulalam,
Amy Navarro Uceda, Aya Nurglieva, Daniela Ochoa Martinez, Makai Opong, Anthony Orellana Garcia, Johan Padilla Galdamez, Ricky Peters, Yenaba Pombor, Victoria Portillo, Baramina Poatman, Cameron Powell, Andy Ramirez Cardenas, Calvin Ramos, Carmen Stephanie Reyes Marquez, Byron Reyes, Sarah Ryder, Charles Rivas Villalobos, Cindy Rivera Diaz, Luis Rivera Rivera, Brian Rivera Salazar, Andy Rivera, Lourdes Rivera, Lucy Rocchio, Charles Russell, David Salmeron, Caroline Shy, Rakeem Smith, Luis Souza Reyes, Muhammad Shambaz, Erica Thompson, Melissa Trejo Rivera, Brian Vallis, Kiri Vasquez Ochoa, Vanessa Vaccarino, Haroon Wakor, Thomas William, Reese Woods, and Meher Wube.
A big congratulations to Team 8-4. Now, would Team 8-5 please rise?
Tamana Alam, Talha Ali, Edwin Arias Benegas, Eva Asensio Sandoval, Khadija Ashfaq, Alexis Bautista Cruz, Carlos Belloso Guzman, Gina Botero Murillo, Christian Brito de Leon, Odalis Calderon Ortega. Noelia Cordova Martinez. Robel Daniel. Camila Diaz Ura. Angelica Enriquez Velasquez. Brian Escobar Cruz. Carlos Escobar Cruz. Diaz. Carlos Escobar Diaz. Josue Estupinian Hernandez. Johan Ferrafino Villalobos. Juliet Ford Ortega. Tatiana Fuentes Saravia. Estefany Garcia. Yabsira Haile. Jose Hernandez Aguilar. Pedro Hernandez Hernandez. Imer Hernandez Irajeta. Luis Hernandez Ventura. Mir Mudassir Husseini. Mahmoud Idelbi. Mohammed Javi. Raja Abdullah Janjua. Kadiatu Kamara. Brian Lizama Montesino. Rodolfo Lopez Hernandez. Amir Arsalan Mada. Hyatt Mahmoud. Abenizer Marhatsion. Angel Meza Reyes. Rakan Mohammed Alamzi. Fozia Mohammed. Fariwar Nori. Isam Nusreddin. David Oduro. Josephine Osei Bansu. Nicole Osorio Villatoro. Marvin Perez Len. Jahaira Ravelo Maldonado. Sarai Rivera Bonilla. Elvia Rodas Martinez. Yemi Romero Asturias. Ibrahim Cisse. Fernando Solorzano Cruz. Adilowit Tecla Jimena. Brittany Torres Salgado. Ana Valenzuela. And Dawit Wagdedesen.
Yeah, Dawit.
Cheyenne Clements. Shirley Staff Labor. Zabula Shirzai. Saeed Masood Mirzai.
In closing, I want to thank first the parents, the teachers, the counselors, and lastly, I want to thank the students. I want to tell you good luck. You will always be an admiral. And please come visit. So thank you.
So Hammond is full of very rich traditions, and we have one last tradition before we allow you to depart to become Titans. The eighth grade class has led the school for the 2015-2016 school year, but now it's time for this class to pass the torch onto a new class, the eighth grade class of 2016-2017. By passing this torch, you are receiving that you are recognizing that your time in middle school has come to an end. As you light this torch, recognize that it represents the qualities that has given you success this year. You have shown dedication, leadership, and responsibility. You have set a strong example for seventh and sixth graders. Carry these characteristics with you into high school, and you will continue to grow. Hamza and Aisha, you received the torch last year. It is now time for you to pass this symbol on to the rising eighth grade class. Would you please light the torch?
Peter and Aaliyah, you have been chosen as representatives for your class. Lighting this torch symbolizes the kindling of those traits that will allow you to set a positive tone for your eighth grade year. Will you and your class lead Francis C. Hammond Middle School with dedication, integrity, and responsibility? As a candle can pass its flame without losing any of its brightness, you will pass these characteristics on to your class. As you, Hamza and Aisha, leave eighth grade and enter high school, pass this torch to the new eighth grade class.